Sun Arena here in Uncasville, Connecticut for the Showtime Boxing Prelims presented by Premier Boxing Champions. It is all brought to you by TGB Promotions in association with D&D Boxing and Showtime. Our first bout of the evening will be 8 rounds in the super welterweight division. Introducing first in the red corner wearing the blue trunks, he weighed at 150 pounds even. His record stands 14 victories, including 3 by knockout, opposite of 4 defeats. Fighting out of San Antonio, Texas, presenting Benjamin Lexican Whitaker. And his opponent across the ring in the blue corner wearing the gold with black trim, he weighed at 150.2 pounds. His record stands undefeated, 15 victories, including 14 by knockout. Fighting out of Toronto, Ontario, Canada, by way of Budapest, Hungary, presenting Zolt the Phenom Dariani. Your referee in charge of the action is Johnny Callis.
Johnny Callis, a referee in charge. Zolt Dariani matching up against Benjamin Whitaker. Happy holidays, everybody. Great to be with all of you here at Mohegan Sun Resort and Casino. This is the biggest step up in competition for Zolt Dariani.
Your instructions in the dressing room. I want you to protect yourself at all times. Above all, obey my commands at all times. First command is right now, touch gloves. When the bell rings, come out and box. Good luck.
So Zolt Dariani and Benjamin Whitaker, they touch gloves. Ray Flores here, Mohegan Sun Resort and Casino. Showtime Boxing Prelims. Benjamin Whitaker in impeccable shape. He's hitting himself. Well, I don't think he'll have a problem at least having punches thrown his way. Compliments of Zolt Dariani, the outstanding amateur who is looking to make a statement here on Showtime Boxing Prelims. A stiff jab to start it off for Zolt Dariani. Dariani in very good physical shape, doubles up on the jab. He is 25 years of age. Originally from Budapest, Hungary, living in Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Numerous national titles back in 2009 through 2014. He won numerous amateur titles, Canadian and Hungary, you know, amateur titles. When it comes to the super welterweight, he calls himself the Phenom. The Zolt Dariani. Dariani long, he's got a nice stiff jab. Benjamin Whitaker looking to crowd him. Whitaker doesn't have the kind of punching power that you would go ahead and deter someone like Dariani to come after you, but he is deceptively powerful. And what I mean by that is he doesn't have the knockouts on his record, but he has the ability to hurt you. So Dariani must be careful if he is to remain undefeated. A high knockout percentage for Dariani as he eats a couple of body shots is coming forward. We're at the midway point of round one between Zolt Dariani and Benjamin Whitaker. Don't forget later tonight, we have Emmanuel Rodriguez matching up against Raymart Caballo. That'll be in our main event for the Bantamweight Championship. Also tonight, we got Jerron Boots Ennis in action. Talk about a guy that is making a lot of noise at 147. He'll battle the battle-tested ready Chris Van Heerden. To begin the night also, Antonio Russell will square up against Juan Carlos Payano. There's a nice left hook that found its destination for Dariani. You are watching Showtime Boxing Prelims here from Mohegan Sun Resort and Casino. Happy holidays, everybody. Hope all of you and your families are doing safe and sound during this rather difficult time with COVID-19. But hopefully, come 2021, we will put that behind us. No fans in attendance here at Mohegan Sun Resort and Casino. And I will tell you that we miss every single one of you. So far, when it comes to missing, Zolt Dariani hasn't missed too much when it comes to his jab in the early going as he looks to come forward upon Benjamin Whitaker. Whitaker looking to crowd him. And that ends round one.
Hey, why don't you start touching him up on that shoulder a little more, too? You know, if I say keep touching, he's taller. All right? And keep that head moving side to side. Give him a little more feints. Keep doing the same feint over and over. Try to time it, okay? Up and down with your work. Keep touching that. Keep touching right here, up and down with that jab. Good control. That's a good route. You do this, okay? Good? Just stay sharp. Okay. You're supposed to jab him to the body, get him tired. All right, set up the right hand, set up the right hand. Bring it to your arm, bring me up.
I'm on the right, right?
Yeah.
Nice. Mm-hmm. Okay,
round number two, this one is scheduled for 8. As we begin the round, Benjamin Whitaker, in his last outing back on September 5, he won a unanimous decision against undefeated DeAndre Smith, as Smith entered that fight with an unblemished record, and Whitaker took it from him. So as I pointed out, the 36-year-old is certainly a force to be reckoned with, and you know, can provide problems to someone making their way up the ranks at 154, like a Zoltariani. As I pointed out, of the 15 victories for Dariani, only 3 of them have come against fighters with winning records. So he's going to start to move up in competition, therefore enter Benjamin Whitaker. Dariani is the kind of guy with the amateur background. He has a fan-friendly style. He said he loves the sport of boxing a great deal. And Whitaker counters him with the right hand over the top. Dariani, under the guidance of Chris Johnson, who happened to be a 1992 Olympic bronze medalist for Canada. A couple of stiff jabs in this second round between Dariani and Whitaker as we're at the midway point of the second. Dariani looking to attack the body of Whitaker. Also, don't forget, we are just over 2 hours away from Showtime Championship Boxing coming up at 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific time. We got a very entertaining triple header, so stick around and get yourself all ready for a fun night of boxing here from Mohegan Sun Resort and Casino. Right now, Zoltariani looking to get into his rhythm. He's got a nice long reach. What I like about Dariani is that he's difficult to hit. He's constantly moving his head, a lot of feints. A Whitaker isn't easy to connect upon either. So we see a little bit of a chess match that is brewing between these two. There's a nice right hand that grazed Dariani. Stiff jab by Whitaker as the San Antonio native advances forward. When we asked Zoltariani about Benjamin Whitaker, he said, there's so much video that we're looking at. I see his style. I see that he likes to box. He's a boxer. He tries to make himself difficult to hit. He's a little bit awkward with his punching as he comes in. And that ends the second. As I mentioned in our main event tonight, Emmanuel Rodriguez matches up against Raymart Caballo.
Okay. How do you feel?
Pick him up and go.
Huh? Top
feel. Okay. I'm just not catching him like I want to.
Well, do it off the feet. Get up on your feet sometime.
Okay.
You're walking. Just get up on your feet sometime. Are you right there?
What do you mean, like step in?
Yeah, get up on your feet.
Okay.
Get them then back out.
Okay.
Send the right hand and back down. Chop the right hand down.
Right? Okay.
How you feel?
Right? Okay.
Here we go.
Seconds out. Let's go.
Round number three. This one is scheduled for eight. You know what I took away from that conversation that Dariani had with his trainer, the Olympic bronze medalist in Chris Johnson, is that he knows what's going on in that ring, but he's articulate in that regard. He goes, yeah, I'm having a hard time finding him. I mean, I think he knows he's not, lying to himself in that ring. And I think he realizes he needs to step it up, because when you get an opportunity like this, when it comes to the worldwide television exposure that Showtime Boxing Prelims gives you the opportunity to do so, you have to look good when giving these coveted TV opportunities. And Dariani is, he's dealt with some personal issues, promotional issues. Now he's ready to go and make a definitive statement at 154. Durrani is really looking, he's looking solid here in the third round. I like his movement as Whitaker comes forward, using that jab to the abdomen. Another overhand right that caught the attention of Whitaker. Durrani with that jab to the body. We'll see if that'll set up that right hand. He has a high knockout percentage, does Durrani. But right now I think he should use his jab, and Whitaker uses a jab to back him off. As we are coming up under a minute to go in the third, and still to come next, Brandon Lee, who's been wiping out his opponents, 11 straight knockouts. He will put his skills to the test against Dakota Linger. So stick around, because that fight has all the makings of providing for some fireworks, especially from the meteoric rise of Brandon Lee. If you haven't seen Brandon Lee fight, you are in for a treat. If he does anything close to what he has displayed in his recent outings, do not blink when that young 21-year-old steps in between those ropes. Durrani coming forward now. Whitaker fighting at the temple that is better serving him. This is something that he needs, a right hand by Durrani. Final moments of the third. Johnny Callis looking to step in between them, and he does so.
I like it, eh? Stay sharp. Put his nose and his lips clean, watching.
Yep, you betcha.
Taking a look at some of the action. A good stiff jab there by Benjamin Whitaker, the 36-year-old from San Antonio. And Durrani was, I think he let him off the hook a little bit too much in that third round. He allowed Whitaker to get settled.
Exactly. The deeper the water, the worse it's for him. Okay? Really good, baby. Let's go.
Well, you heard it in the corner with Benjamin Whitaker, like, let's take him into those deep waters. He's fighting at the pace that serves him well, so I have to give him credit. It's not just a lack of, activity by Durrani. It is the fact that Benjamin Whitaker is frustrating Durrani to a point. And that's that Whitaker is 11 years older than Durrani. But hey, you know what they say? Oh,
no,
that's
knockdown,
a slip.
No knockdown.
Johnny Callis rolls it a slip. You know what they say? 36 is the new 26. So I'm not just saying that because I'm 34, but it's truly evident how prize fighters are just so much more aware with nutrition and training methods, and we're seeing fighters last a little bit longer than what we saw maybe 15, 20, 30 years ago. but there are exceptions to the rule, including Manny Pacquiao, who just celebrated his 42nd birthday on Thursday. I call him the eighth wonder of the world, the eight division world champion, Manny Pacquiao. Still a world champion at 147, and Duranyi has his sights set on becoming a world champion one day, but he's got to be able to get past barometers and fighters like a Benjamin Whittaker in order to get to that contender level. As we look at Duranyi, and he gets sprayed with a couple left hooks, Duranyi is a prospect who's looking to graduate to contender status. You know, had a lot of hype behind him when he made his pro debut and stuff, and he's been inactive, but now he's back, and we'll see if he can end 2020 with a bang and then start off 2021 more active. And look, this has been a difficult year for all prize fighters simply because the fact of COVID-19 having to derail the sport of boxing for him. I mean, PBC didn't have an event. We haven't been here on Showtime. We went from like March through August without an event here on Showtime. So it was not the easiest time for prize fighters, and we certainly missed it, but we're glad we're back. Under a minute to go here in this fourth round with Zolt Duranyi and Benjamin Whittaker. But the point of the story that I was trying to make is that a lot of guys have been active this year because of the worldwide pandemic. So I'm not just singling out Zolt Duranyi because of his inactivity. I mean, that is pretty much academic across the board for most prize fighters. Nice left hook to the body by Duranyi. Now he's letting his hands go. Look at that hand speed by Duranyi, but answering back is Benjamin Whittaker. Final moments of the fourth between Zolt Duranyi and Benjamin Whittaker. Whittaker coming forward, missing that with that jumping left hook, as we are now halfway home. Taking a look at that. Boom, that was a nice left hook there by Duranyi, or at least from my broadcast position. It looked like it landed with full impact. Let's take a look at it again. It's a sharp little left hook. I don't think it landed with full impact from my position. I thought so.
And you're sitting there too much with the jab. Come on, move the head, step back. Pounding that fucking thing. Come on, wake the fuck up. You hear me? Wake up.
Should I step back counter or block counter? Anything?
All of them. You're working on all of them, though. You see?
Go, Chris.
Well, there's a sense of urgency from the corner of Zolt Duranyi. As we apologize for the language, this is a family show here on YouTube, but there is definitely the corner of Zolt Duranyi is not happy with his performance. They almost feel like he is being outworked by Benjamin Whittaker in certain aspects and certain moments of the fight. So I know that his trainer, Chris Johnson, is trying to urge him and light a fire under him to try to get what many believe is a budding young contender in Zolt Duranyi. And Benjamin Whittaker is the kind of guy that can frustrate you. He is a solid technical fighter. You know, he just handed a prospect a loss back during Labor Day weekend. Now Duranyi coming forward, they crowd up, and now Whittaker trying to wrestle Duranyi with his back on the ropes.
Keep your hands off the back of his head.
Johnny Callis telling Duranyi about the holding behind the head. Good stiff jab with a left hook by Whittaker. Steps in and caught the attention of the undefeated prospect in Duranyi. Whittaker coming forward. Whittaker's confidence is starting to grow in this fight. And in this little peekaboo style that Duranyi is trying to implore is not serving him well here in the fifth, as we are just over 50% of the way done. Hey, don't forget, we are just under 2 hours away before we go live at Showtime Championship Boxing A good left hook that sprayed Durrani from Whitaker. Whitaker looks to be in very good rhythm. He's relaxed. Durrani is coming forward, but he's not throwing with as much frequency as you would hope if you're in his corner. Under a minute remaining here in the fifth. And there's a right hand that connected off the left side of the skull of Durrani. As you look at Benjamin Whitaker, you know he's a tricky guy. And you know that if you are trying to graduate in your career, you have to beat guys like that. But he is a difficult opponent. And if you aren't careful and bring your A game, he can beat you. And lo and behold, I think this is a close fight. Now, I'm not a judge by any stretch of the imagination, so I will leave that to our unofficial scorer, Steve Farhood, who will be on Showtime Championship Boxing later tonight. So I will not give you, but I will, at least from my vantage point, I think it is a close fight between Zol Durrani and Benjamin Whitaker. A right to the body by Whitaker. And that ends the fifth. On to the sixth we go. Taking a look at some of the action again from the fifth. There's that right hand that sprayed Durrani. Good stiff jab there.
The lay of the rounds is better for us, okay? And touch both sides of that body to get inside, okay? Good job. Hey, keep all those little movements up. Hey, and another thing, bait them. You know how you're just back there?
I'm trying to bait
them. Yeah, exactly. Hey, but let them run to the uppercut. Okay, let them run to the uppercut. And go to the body. Body, and then come to the uppercut. Okay, be creative. But main thing, stay sharp. Stay focused, okay? Sharp and focused, all right? Beautiful, let's keep it up.
If I'm in the corner of Benjamin Whitaker,
Alex has been known to have control
with what he has seen out of the 36-year-old from San Antonio. Round number six, this one is scheduled for eight. Zol Durrani needs to make some significant progress if he's to maintain and hold his undefeated record. Ray Flores here at Mohegan Sun Resort and Casino. It is the 19th time that Showtime Championship Boxing has been here at this wonderful venue on the East Coast, the eighth time since the pandemic. It has predominantly been the home of Showtime Championship Boxing during the COVID-19 era, with the bubble being in place by PBC, also the promotional entities like TGB Promotions and wonderful staff within Showtime Championship Boxing, keeping all of us safe and sound, getting us tested regularly and making sure everyone's following protocol. But right now, Benjamin Whitaker isn't following what is on the script for a young prospect, as he is providing some very solid opposition to Zol Durrani. Now, Durrani, now living in Toronto, he's originally from Budapest, Hungary, and had an extensive amateur career in both countries, picking up numerous national titles. It's a push as we are coming up on the halfway point of the sixth round. This has been a busy week for Premier Boxing Champions. This is the third card in a week. Started off last week on Showtime Championship Boxing with Chris Colbert looking unbelievable. Boy, did he look good. There's a right hand that connected by Durrani. Another right hand, two right hands, and Whitaker sort of shrugged him off as to say, is that all you got? And he sticks him with the jab right in his face and comes back with the right to the body.
Zol, don't measure.
Corner of Durrani telling him don't measure, meaning if you are going to throw your jab, do it with authority and don't use it, don't just kind of leave it out there and paw at it. Double jab as Durrani eats a couple of jabs. Shots to the body and the uppercut. It was like an uppercut left hook variation of that. Back comes Durrani. Chris Colbert, the lookout, standing against Jaime Arboleda last week here on Showtime Championship Boxing. And I would gather to say that Colbert was the one who won the evening with a dazzling performance. Who's going to win the night this evening? Final moments of the six between the undefeated Zoll Durruti and Benjamin Whitaker, the veteran out of San Antonio. To the seventh we go.
What you got left? What you got left here? You got a leg.
Two to go.
No. You got two rounds left. I mean, the last couple of rounds, you're losing.
I'm losing these last
Fuck yes. Bro, you just been sitting watching TV, watching the motherfuckers work.
Come on. Cold water on my back.
You just been watching TV, bro. Stop watching the motherfucker take him out. He's here for you to be taking him out. Look at me. Take him out. Step to this motherfucker. He ain't better than you. You're making him better than me.
Good job. Stay focused. Stay focused.
Well, two different trains of thought in the corners. For the corner, Benjamin Whitaker, stay focused. And the trainer of Zoll Durruti, he's got to be thinking, what is going on? Chris Johnson told him, are you watching TV? Like, what are you doing in this? Like, you're making this guy look better than what he is. And I'm glad all of you guys are watching at home and are watching television here on Showtime Boxing Prelims, and you're watching the action. But man, oh man, frustration without question from Chris Johnson. And again, I'm a little perplexed at the fact that he isn't letting his hands go. And now Whitaker has got his confidence is soaring. He's in a groove. He's in a rhythm. His pacing, his timing as well. And Durruti, in my opinion, at least from an outsider's perspective, not the unofficial judge like the expert, I call him the Encyclopedia of Boxing, Steve Farhood. I think that Durruti is behind in this fight, and Whitaker might be in line for the upset. You gotta love prize fighting. You never know on any given night. But Durruti has got to come forward. We'll see if he can bring something significant in this final round and a half. I mean, look, he can't fall asleep, and there's a right hand that connected for Durruti. Durruti has a very high knockout percentage of over 90%. So you cannot underestimate the fact that he does have that quote unquote one punch eraser. But against a guy like a mover and who is as crafty as Benjamin Whitaker, you've got to be wondering that he's got to find a way to start tagging him and blasting away on him now. There's a right that connected by Durruti. As we are approaching 65 seconds to go here in the seventh. Happy holidays, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us wherever you are around the world. It is Showtime Boxing Prelims. Coming up next, Brandon Lee, the undefeated knockout artiste, will put his 11th straight knockout streak on the line against Dakota Linger. That is up next. Again, Benjamin Whitaker kind of fighting in spurts. He's economical when it comes to his movements.
Step back. Don't punch. Don't push.
He doesn't waste much energy or motion. He's very tuned with his body and doesn't waste much motion. Well, we are approaching the final stages of this seventh stanza between Zoll Durruti and Benjamin Whitaker. Durruti may need something significant as we head towards the eighth.
That was good, okay. Can you shoot that jab?
Is this eight?
Can you shoot that jab to the chest? Come up to the chest.
What is this? This is eight.
Uh-huh.
Is this eight? I think so.
Just keep going. But you hear me down? You feel that too. He knows he's down. He doesn't have to gamble. But you already know the deal, bro. You already know where we're at.
This is the last round?
This is like when you're in the gym and you're competing against some fucking guys. You gotta let him go.
Should I let him come to me and call?
You gotta go to him, sir. You gotta knock him. You gotta knock him the fuck out, sir. No, you can't wait for him to come. You gotta go to him.
Go, seconds out, seconds out.
You gotta be an animal this fucking long. You got
to. Well, Chris Johnson urging Zoltan Runny. You've got to be an animal this round. You have to knock him out. I don't think it gets much more of a feeling of desperation when your lead trainer is giving you those implicit instructions. For Benjamin Whitaker, they know if he remains upright, likely he should be in line to get the victory. Again, I am not an unofficial judge, but it looks like the fact that Benjamin Whitaker, for the most part, has given Duranyim a boxing lesson for the most part. There's a nice stiff jab by Whitaker, and Whitaker sticks that jab, snapping back the head of Duranyim. But Duranyim had a lot of power and extensive amateur background, but he's fighting a guy in Benjamin Whitaker. You know, if you would just look at the style and the bravado and the confidence of Benjamin Whitaker, you know, fighters from Texas, a lot of them are aggressive, come forward fighters, good solid fundamentals. Names like Errol Spence, along with Mario Barrios, come to mind, Ahmad Juarez as well. But when I look at Benjamin Whitaker, he reminds me of a fighter from Philadelphia who's crafty, who's intelligent, who's slick, just very much so in tune with where he is everywhere around the ring. We're at the halfway point of the eighth and final round. If you're Zoltan Runny, he's got to empty out the tank now and start to blast away upon Whitaker. Now, I know easier said than done here at ringside from my position, but Runny needs something significant.
Shot punch.
Now Duranyi trying to crowd and drive Whitaker to the perimeter of the ring. Now he's got to let his hands go. This is where he has his opportunity, and he just gets sprayed with the right cross, and now he retreats backwards. He may have been hurt from that right to left hook, and now Duranyi is on the ropes, and a left hook to the body. He tried to be aggressive, he ate a couple of shots and said, oh, I don't really like that power too much. And as we pointed out at the beginning part of the fight, that from a statistical standpoint, Whitaker doesn't have the highest knockout percentage, but he has enough power to hurt you and really sting you. And that's exactly what he did to Duranyi. A right uppercut that connected for the San Antonio product. I am mightily impressed by the performance of Benjamin Whitaker tonight. Heavy underdog coming in against another undefeated prospect. No issues for the most part. And just looking like it's another day at the office. And for Zoltan Runny, you got to be thinking. I mean, listen, Whitaker took it to him. Final moments of the eighth and final round. Now he's coming forward and he gets blasted with the right cross. That ends the fight. Boy. What a tale of two different performances. Benjamin Whitaker, that was a, I would say, borderline masterful boxing lesson for him against the young prospect in Zolt Duranyi. And if you're Duranyi, quite a bit to assess and consider, because we just didn't see him throw enough punches to make an impact upon Benjamin Whitaker. Let's take a look back and watch some of the action and how this fight unfolded. There's a good stiff jab there by Benjamin Whitaker. This could be the second straight win over an undefeated prospect. There's that counter shot by Whitaker. Nice stiff jab as Whitaker, to be undeterred, walking down the power puncher. That nice left hook by Whitaker. Here they were in close distance. That right uppercut, the short right uppercut that his trainer was telling him to use. And Duranyi showing some of his power with that right, but there wasn't enough of it, in my estimation. And Zoltan Runny And Benjamin Whitaker should absolutely be very pleased with his performance. And Durrani, you would gather that Chris Johnson is probably livid with what he saw out of his pupil. But again, he's only 25, and this was a step up in competition, and I'm not the kind of guy that's gonna write off a fighter after one or two losses, even multiple losses. This is boxing. In my opinion, losing happens. And guys have been able to respond and become world champions after one or two losses. You look at Julian Williams, you look at Jamal Herring, you look at Jason Rosario. They've all come back and won world titles after one or two losses. And now, with the official decision, we send it up to a ring announcer. Here is Miguel Flores.
Ladies and gentlemen, majority decision, Benjamin Blaxigan Whitaker.
Benjamin Whitaker defeats Zolt Durrani, handing him the first loss of his professional career. That's the second straight victory over an unbeaten prospect for Benjamin Whitaker. Now, I didn't agree with the draw 76-76 by John McKay. 79-73, 77-75. Benjamin Whitaker taking home the W here tonight, and another impressive outing for the 36-year-old from San Antonio.